Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we're going to go over how to use the choose function in Excel. The choose function returns a value based on the order of the value's location within the function. Let's take a look. I have here four numbers listed and want to see which is the third number on the list. We can do this with choose. So we'll come here and write equals choose, open parentheses, and the index number. This is the location where we'll type the number of the position that we want returned. So in this case, we'll use C2, comma, and then we need to enter each value that we want the choose function to select from. And we need to do it in the order that we want the selection to happen. So we'll select each one of these individually. And it's also important to select each value one at a time. Otherwise, they're all going to be grouped as just one value, and that's not going to help us for this example. So then we can just click enter and we get a value error. But once we come back here and we type the number 3 requesting the value that's in the third position, you see that it says the number 7. Now, as I mentioned a moment ago, the order is important. So if I was to switch the cell in our formula that's in the third position, which is B8, to say with B6, and we'll make this one B8, notice how now what's in the position of the third value changes. So it has more to do with the order in which those items are in the choose function than in the order that they're actually listed. So that's just something to keep in mind as you build the inputs for your function. So while that seems interesting, it doesn't seem particularly useful. That is, until we combine the choose function with other formulas. For example, on my screen are average daily temperatures for 4 different weeks. I can use the choose function to help me find the average temperature for a selected week. And by the way, if you're finding this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for even more tips. So to find the average weekly temperature, we can combine the choose function with the average function. So we'll write equals average, open parentheses, and then we'll insert the choose function, open parentheses, and for the index, we'll use cell B2, comma, and then select just the values for each week. Or, like, I've given mine named ranges to make it go a little bit faster, so we can select them or type them in, as I'm doing here. Four. Then closer parentheses and select enter. So what we've done in this function is taken all of the temperatures by week and grouped them into a value. So week 1 in the choose function is value 1, week 2 is value 2, and so on. And then here in cell B2, we can choose which week we want to see the average for. So let's say I want to see the average temperature for week 2. Simply type the number 2, and it gives us an average weekly temperature of 72. And you know what? We can make our temperature data look better. So let's format these so they look like temperatures. So we'll select all of the values that are temperature, including the result of the choose function, and then right click and select format cells. Then select custom, and we'll just select a 0 is fine. I don't have any decimal points I'll be using. Then pressing the alt button along with 0176 on your number pad on your keyboard. Once you let go of the alt key, we should have the degree symbol. So click OK to format our temperatures as temperatures. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to use the choose function in Microsoft Excel. If you did, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.